Once brought to the brink of extinction, the famous Eagle Lake trout has been brought back to healthy numbers with improved water management practices and the efforts of the California Department of Fish and Game's hatchery programs.
20% of the fish that the department plants into the lake are marked with what we call a freeze brand. Mm-hmm. And that looks like one. Usually they're in this location. But we use liquid nitrogen and a branding iron. It's like 320 some odd degrees below zero, and it will just like branding cattle, you know. So it's usually about the size of a quarter, and on the back, that one. But on the right side, it came from Crystal Lake Hatchery, and it's anterior to the dorsal fin, so it was planted on an odd numbered year. If it was behind the dorsal fin, it'd be an even numbered year. So based on the length, fork length of 17.8 inches with a growth rate of about 2 inches a year, until they get, you know, past about the 20 inch mark, then they slow down. So an odd year. This one was probably planted in the fall of 2009.
It's opening day of trout season on Eagle Lake, which every year attracts anglers from across the region. Today, we're fishing with Rick Kennedy, who operates Tightline's Guide Service, Shyla Hale and Chris Stewart from Fernly, Nevada, and Gary Miralles of Shasta
Tackle
Company.
We're going to start off this morning with a variety of baits. This is the Wiggle Hoochie. This has been very productive for just about everything we fish for, and I have a feeling it's going to do real well today. We also got some cripplers on the top. I like running the cripplers on the surface because they rotate and roll a lot, and they create a lot of vibration. So we can actually watch the rod tip and tell that it's working. On the outsides, we're going to run down no deeper than about 12 feet. We got some humdingers there, and then we have a spinner hoochie as well. So we're kind of mixing it up this morning until we figure out what they want. And once we get on something, then we can switch later. But right now, it's weather's changing, and we got to use as many things we can, just try to figure out what they're going to want, but we'll get them.
This week, we're trout fishing on Eagle Lake, and then we'll take a trip to the Oregon coast for halibut, and also take a tour of the Oregon Tackle Manufacturing Facility in Portland, Oregon. I'm Justin Wolf, and this is Angler West Television. Despite a changing barometer and the threat of stormy weather this Memorial Day weekend, Eagle Lake is still
keep
kicking out
up a
some
bit.
Nice fish.
Okay. Yeah, perfect.
Oh yeah, there you go.
Just as long as that line's tight, that's what you gotta. So that's why I name my business Tight Lines.
Let me check your drag just a little bit. There we go. Keep reeling.
What's my depth?
Well, that's stopping you. That's gonna be
10-3.
It's going to be a pretty good sized fish, I think. Right here, Rick. Fish?
Come take this. Okay. It's a nice fish. Just start reeling. Stop for a second. Okay. Just keep it tight. Take your time, because I want to try to get this other fish in, so take your time.
Well, that fish is just not letting you get budged. Here it comes. Right there, Rick. About ready. Oh, nice.
Okay. Okay, when that fish breaks the water, uh-huh, just slow down. Don't give him slack, but if you horse him when he's out of the water, he's gonna throw that hook.
Okay.
Yeah, just real slow.
It's all right. Come on, keep reeling. Both of you keep reeling.
Okay.
Keep reeling.
He's right there.
There you
keep
go.
Reeling.
Awesome. That's
keep
nice
reeling.
Fish.
Keep reeling. Reel, reel.
Keep reeling.
Woo!
Check
Look
it
at
out.
That.
I love it.
Yes. All right.
That orange is the color. That's for sure.
Nice.
Got one on the.
But mine's bigger than his.
Got one on the Wiggle Hoochie with the orange yellow, and then one on the red gold humdinger.
This one's mine. Oh yeah, wow! Look at that.
Yeah, that was yours right there.
Oh wow!
Nice fish, both of them.
Good job.
Good job, you guys. Those double hooks, boy. When they get both of them get in there, they don't usually come off. So it's a good thing.
Oh, good job.
There you
Thanks.
Go. Good job, guys.
Oh yay!
Look at that. Nothing wrong with those fish.
This episode is brought to you in part by the California Department of Boating and Waterways, Shasta Tackle Company, Max Lure, and Max High Definition Sunglasses. Welcome back to Eagle Lake. I'm Justin Wolf. It's a cool start to the summer at Eagle Lake, but so far the fishing is red hot for Chris Stewart and Shyla Hale, who are fishing with Rick Kennedy and Gary Miralles.
On the backside, the opposite tape. Now what the scent will do, obviously, you know, it attracts them, but when they come up on the lure is going through the water, it attracts them, they move in on it, and then when they get right in behind the bait, because they'll literally come right up behind it, and they'll smell that scent, and that's the final, you know, attractant they need to, boom, get them to hit.
I'm gonna make a tight turn as soon as Gary gets that one line in.
Okay.
We're gonna turn around and go back over that that little shelf and pick up a couple more.
Oh, I don't want him to get in that other one. Oh, he's pulling the line.
He's all right.
Boy, there's something he doesn't like.
Oh, awesome. A little bit smaller, but still good.
Hurry.
Look at that. Light, bright pink.
He's a little different color. So I'm thinking we probably ought to release him.
Yeah, that's a little smaller fish. We'll do better than that.
This lure is working because it's bright orange and it's the same color as my fingernail polish today. And I said that that's probably going to be one of the things that's going to catch the fish. And it's doing its job.
Those guys have been tearing us up over there. So we're going to have to put an orange humdinger on it. Seems to be the hot ticket. That's one thing you want to do, guys. When you're hooking fish on one color, switch. Get more of them on there. Now we started off the morning using a variety of lures and colors, and that orange humdinger was hot. So I switched over to an orange on the other side here and didn't have it in the water just probably 30 seconds and got another fish.
Okay, that's a nice fish. So just don't horse him. If he wants to go, let him run. Okay, here we go. Keep on reeling. Keep on reeling.
Oh, nice fish.
Keep on reeling. Come up, up.
Boy, he's going.
Up, up.
Boy, are they feisty or what?
Yeah, they're nice.
Keep on reeling, don't
nice
stop.
Cold water.
There you go.
Nice fish.
Nice Eagle Lake trout. Eagle Lake, you'll probably see it when we take the boat out of the water. We'll have a bunch of white, like chalk on the boat. It's a very high alkali lake. It's one of two fish that live in this lake. The Tui Chub is another one. But they're starting to plant them in a lot of other lakes around the state. But they're just, when you go to fillet these and eat them, they look more like a salmon than a trout. Just bright red meat, delicious, good eating fish. Grow fast and fight hard. I am using 6-pound P-Line CXX. I've been using that line for years, both for trout and kokanee, and I'll tell you, it is a...
look at that, bud! What did I tell you?
Stole the one good lure.
You know what I did there was I actually took some of these eyes.
That's the ones you put the dots on?
Yeah, we have not been getting hit on this lure like we should, so I put four of these dots on there, two of each color. Just put it out there, told them we were going to hit the big fish, boom, instantly.
Just like that.
That was great. I love it.
This first time at Eagle Lake, this is great fishing. Great weather, a lot of fish.
Down again.
Whoa.
There you went. Let it right out.
Just like that.
Right here. There's one. All we did was put those dots on there.
We ran down here south of what they call Shrimp Island and found some warmer water, about 2 degrees warmer than what we were fishing earlier, and took about less than probably 2 minutes on, we got one on.
I couldn't even get all the lures in the water. We barely got that thing in there and wham. All right.
There's something wrong here.
That fish is ready to net.
Go ahead. Okay, let's lift up. Oh, he's on that other line. That's what's wrong. Go ahead and come on up. It's a nice fish.
Nice
fish. I'm gonna come around.
Oh, good fish.
Eagle Lake's elevation is over 5,000 feet,
nice
which
fish.
Can be very cold water that can be dangerous if you should fall overboard.
That's why we wear these vests. Fall out.
Yeah.
You know, at least you're floating. You could drown real quick on a day like today.
A lot of people, when you can't catch your breath.
As cold as it is.
Especially in October. We spend a lot of time in October, November up here when the water temperature is, running in the high 30s. And the guy doesn't realize that this lake, for the most part, is a pretty shallow lake. And you think, you can fall in here and get out easy. But when you hit that 38, 35 degree water, about that fast, you're...
Can't catch your breath.
You're swimming for about,
Not just...
About 5 minutes and you're done.
This episode of Angler West TV is brought to you in part by Procure Bait Sense, P-Line, Neil's Master Lures of Finland, and Van Warmer Resorts. It's your typical cool, foggy morning on the Oregon coast. A day like any other day, a fisherman might go out after salmon, rockfish, or lingcod, or maybe albacore tuna, or crabs. But today, we're heading out with guide Dave Steele, Dave Jasmer, and Phil Pirone of Procure for another great-tasting treat off the Oregon coast menu, the Pacific Halibut.
I marinate my bait in Procure's butt juice and garlic plus, and I add a little extra flavoring of my own, and but what I do is I put my bait together the night before, and then I don't have to worry about it that morning. And I run two baits to a line, and because these are already set with hooks, then I just snap them on. By doing that, I've got quick change when I need to change baits for whatever reason. Phil's got a fish on. Yes, sir. And he has about 550 feet of line to bring up. So he's going to have fun with this. Now you're going to understand why electric reels are so nice.
Oh, I know. I know the program better.
Yeah, I know.
Oh, real man.
When you see red line, tell me.
That was garlic plus that got hit on.
I think it's respectable. I don't think it's really big.
Yeah, we'll find. Yeah, it's funny about these halibut. I've seen halibut come up, and we catch nice 50 pounders, and they don't really fight on the way up until they get to the top. And then I've seen the 20 pounders that just pull, and you think you got a good one until you get it up to the top, and it's like not much to it. But he's getting a little bit of tug out of this one. Look at that rod tip bend. Now it's coming with him right now. We're out of Newport. We're out about 30 miles or so. This is called the Ranch, and we just put our lines in the water in this area, and that, like I say, that hit within 5 minutes of being down. Sometimes it happens that way. The key is we got to keep our lines down on the bottom, and we'll see what we come up with here.
Your call.
No, it's your choice. That's probably about a 32 incher.
That's one of the nice things about the Chicken Ranch. You sort through some smaller fish, but there's always some decent 45, 50, 60, 70 pounders hiding here. And once in a while, you got to sort through a few. Sometimes you get all big ones right away, but sometimes you get 5 or 6 of the smaller ones. We let them go. They're not harmed. They swim right back to the bottom. They're not like a rockfish. They have no problem going back down again. And you sort them out, and you get the bigger fish. Yeah, it's amazing. Some of the days they want the garlic plus, and other days they want the bud juice with the anise in it. So, it's a good combination. Try one of each. The other one you want to integrate now is the tuna. Halibut love it. So do the lingcod. So, if you haven't tried the bloody tuna oil, that's a good one to put into your mix.
That time we got it.
Here's our first keeper in the boat.
35 pounds, I think, right in that range. Nice meat. They'll be nice. They'll be about probably 25 pounds of meat come out of this. It'll be such a really good eater. Generally, what we do is run a drift here. A drift being maybe a 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 mile section. And I'm back trolling a little bit. I'm slowing my drift down. I'm just letting the current take us in whatever direction it's taking us. And as we go through some fish, now what I want to do is go back and start through those fish that we just went through. Come on, get in here. There we go. Turn. I don't know that I got it. Yeah, I got it.
Fresh halibut is truly outstanding to eat. Now here's Phil Pirone with a simple way to fillet your fish without wasting any meat.
You can save that knife right now. It's ready to go. Come up on my fish, right along the fin line here. I come on the other side, my knife tip right in here like that. And again, right along the fin line, up to the belly. Your stomach's gonna start right in this area here. So you can cut it from right about here and come under the fin, come around it like that. The closer you get up to the gill plate, this is all meat up here, you don't wanna be wasting it. Come all the way here, this is all meat all the way to here. So again, you don't wanna be wasting it. Then if you look real careful, you'll see this center line. Go right down here on halibut like that, it comes up like that, curls a little bit. You wanna try to follow that line. If you're not sure where, you can look on here and you'll see where that line gets picked up in the meat. And right about there, just follow it right down the center line, right to the spine, like this. You can use the flat of the knife and just flick that knife right along there, come in like that, find the spine and just lay it flat on the spine, and follow it right on up like that. And you'll see how pretty this comes out. Not a lot of waste. Now look at that. That is an absolutely beautiful chunk of meat.
The rigs used to catch these halibut were custom made by Oregon Tackle, an icon of Northwest fishing.
This is Oregon Tackle gear.
After this break, we'll take a guided tour of the Oregon Tackle manufacturing facility with the owner, Doug Hayes.
It gets loaded onto here, and it gets delivered right to your store.
Today's episode of Angler West TV is brought to you in part by Qualicum River's Winter Harbor Resort, Dove Island Lodge, the Boomerang Tool Company, and Coldwell Banker CNC Properties. The halibut rigs used today were made by Oregon Tackle, that for decades has provided Northwest anglers with a wide variety of high-quality tackle components designed specifically for the Northwest, like the new Oregon Tackle bottom bouncer.
One thing unique about Oregon Tackle is everything's manufactured right here in Oregon, right here in the Northwest, to fish in the Northwest. We take a lot of pride in that. Whenever you see this truck driving around town, you know these are products that are made right here in your backyard. This is where it all starts right here. The orders come in to carry over the fax machine. We go ahead and write them out. Then they come on this way over here. What you're looking at here is different orders for different stores. They ship out on pallets, they ship out weekly. So what we got going on over here is we're making shad darts. These are all hand done, it's pretty meticulous. They go ahead and powder coat them, paint them, then they come over here and they get dried, then they get packaged. So all the blades that we have here are hand painted. They're done right here in-house. We've got hundreds of different colors and hundreds of different sizes. A lot of these are sent out just as blades, but if you look down here, we also tie up spinners, and we've got hundreds and hundreds of different types of spinners that we send out. They're all hand done. You've got all the different sizes and colors, and the rainbows, the green dots, the clam shells, and then if you look over here, you have blades that are just plain. You've got hammered brass, you've got nickel, you've got gold. The reason you have so many different types of blades is because of the fishermen. They tend to, on a sunny day, they want to go to a rainbow color. On a cloudy day, they might want to use nickel. On a different type of day, they might want to use gold. Hammered on one side, reverse hammered, deep cup. There's all types of different blades that we use for different types of water in different situations. The same thing with the beads that we have over here. They'll use different types of beads, which are faceted or just the round beads. Again, hundreds of different colors, hundreds of different sizes, depending on water conditions and where you're fishing. So over here is where we paint the blades. It's about a 15-step process to get to a finished product. What we got Adam doing here right now is he's doing some chartreuse green dot. Very popular color here in the Northwest. What we're doing here is we're making pencil lead. We make 3/16 and 1/4 inch hollow and solid. It comes off of a 9-pound pig is what we call it. Goes into our extruder here. It comes out in lead wire. And then what happens, it gets rolled into 1-pound rolls and 5-pound rolls and 25-pound rolls. So we pour thousands of pounds of lead every year. This is the raw material, how it starts. These are 40-pound ingots. They come from here, they go right into the melting pots. The guys take and they'll put them into the different molds for the different sizes. We do cannonballs, we do pyramids, we do all types of different kinds of lead. Right now we're pouring the downrigger weights here. We've got some 12-pounders, some 8-pounders. He's getting ready to powder coat them. When they're finished, this is what the finished product will come out like. What we've got here is a slinky maker. They come in different sizes from 175 up to 300. We bottle them like this. The guys will put them in the parachute cord. It's an alternative to the pencil lead. They like it really well. It's flexible, moves through the water, tracks on the bottom real well. Okay, this is the new Oregon Tackle swim baits. They come in 6 different sizes. They come 3 with the heads, 3 headless. There's a variety of different colors. These are actually used for tuna, salmon, bass, walleye. They work really well. The tail tracks in the water real nice, has good action, and we've got a lot of positive response off of these. So what we have here is the Oregon Tackle Steely Bug. They work really good for steelhead fishing. On the Sandy River and the Clackamas, they're just deadly. We've got Richard over here tying them right now. He can produce about 100 of these in an hour. They come in multiple colors and different sizes. These get packaged up in 6 per pack, and off to the stores they go.
Hey, thanks for watching today's episode of Angler West TV. You know, it's only with the sponsor support that the show is made possible, so please thank them when you can. Now get out there and do some great fishing.